Hey WordPress fans. Today I want to take a look at how to set up a new website on GoDaddy's Managed WordPress Hosting platform. GoDaddy's been doing a lot of work lately on their onboarding process for new WordPress customers, and so that's what I want to take a look at today. First off, let's take a look at how to access our Managed WordPress sites. You can go to the top right-hand corner and click the drop-down for your account. From here, just go ahead and click on My Products. That'll take you to a screen that looks very similar to this. You may have more products in your list, but the one that we're looking for is this Managed WordPress Websites product. Let's go ahead and click the green Manage button. This assumes that you don't already have any WordPress sites in your GoDaddy hosting, so this is a fresh GoDaddy account with a brand new WordPress website. Go ahead and click the Add Site button. Right off the bat, GoDaddy gives us two options for the type of website. We can either choose a brand new site if we're starting from scratch, or we can migrate an existing site that we may have hosted somewhere else. For this tutorial, I'm going to choose brand new site. For our domain name, we have two options. If we don't have a domain name yet, we can come down to the bottom and choose use a temporary domain. This is one that GoDaddy creates for us that we can use to set up a new website and do all of our testing before we're ready to publish it live onto a domain name. The second option is to use a domain name that you already own. If you have domain names registered with GoDaddy, they will appear here in a list. If you do not, then you can also type a domain name that you own, perhaps have registered elsewhere, and then that's where this info box comes into play that will require you to update your DNS to the new GoDaddy hosting server. That's only if your domain is registered somewhere other than GoDaddy. For this tutorial, I'm going to choose the temporary domain. We're going to get that all set up first, and then I will transfer that over to the live domain when we're ready to launch the site. The next option here is to choose a data center. We have two options for North America or Europe. You want to choose the location that is closest to where most of your visitors will be coming from. I'm going to choose North America. The next step is to create a WordPress login. This is how you'll access the backend area of your WordPress site to make updates to the website. So go ahead and choose a username and create a password and confirm it. Once you've done that, go ahead and click Install. You'll see this little screen here that says it's installing. It can take a couple of minutes. After about 2 or 3 minutes, it'll say WordPress was successfully installed, and we can get started or go to our dashboard. I'm going to go ahead and choose Get Started and see what kind of process that takes me through. So here we're presented with a nice little wizard setup that we can go through. It says that we've got pre-built websites and themes that we can use, as well as a bunch of searchable images in an image library. This is just to help us get our website up and running faster. So let's go ahead and start the wizard. We've got a couple of options here for what type of website we have. Website and blog, blog only, or online store. I'm going to go ahead and choose website and blog. I think that'll be the most common for a lot of people, unless, of course, you are running a store and selling products, in which case you'll want to choose online store. The next thing they ask for is industry. You can go ahead and click this drop-down and then search for the industry that your website is a part of. Next, you'll be asked to give your website a title. The next thing they'll ask for here is tagline. You cannot leave this blank, so you do need to enter a tagline. So go ahead and enter something here. You can always update this later once you finish the wizard. The next set of information is some contact info. This is to help your website visitors get in touch with you if they should have questions. So go ahead and enter your email, your phone number, a fax if you have it, an address, and you can also add your social media profiles at the bottom. Once you've added all your contact information as well as your social media profiles, go ahead and click Continue. The final step in the setup wizard is to choose a theme or a design for your website. Don't fret with this decision because you can always change this later. This is just something right now to get you started. GoDaddy gives you 10 options. They are all designed by GoDaddy in-house, by GoDaddy's design team. So go ahead and just look through these themes. You can hover over them and click the preview button. That'll allow you to see what your website will look like. It just has some filler content in here for now because we haven't added any content yet. But you can get an idea of what this theme will look like. And then you can go ahead and click the X in the top left corner. That will bring you back to the theme wizard and you can preview a different theme. So again, don't spend too much time on this. If there's something here that you really like, go ahead and choose it and go for it. If you don't see anything here you like, just go ahead and pick something and you can always change that later. I'm going to choose just the first option here as the primer theme. Once you've decided which one you want, go ahead and click on that theme. It'll show you a preview and then click this blue select button here in the top left corner. You'll get this message that says not to refresh the page. GoDaddy is just installing and setting up your theme. It could take up to 30 seconds. Once your theme has finished installing, GoDaddy takes you to the WordPress Customizer, and they're giving you some prompts here on how to edit your site. They're showing you which areas of the site you can go ahead and change and update. So this message here, it just gives you a brief little note to update your site content, layout, color scheme, and more using all of these options here on the left. This is the regular WordPress Customizer. So we're no longer in GoDaddy's quick start setup wizard. We are now actually inside of WordPress's customizer. Here you'll see as we go through this little wizard, it mentions that this icon right here is to edit the body content on the page. So this will open up a page builder in a new window. We'll experiment with that here in a second. You can also watch a video on how to customize your site with the customizer. Let's go ahead and just take a quick look and see what this is. All right, so this appears to be a video from WP 101. GoDaddy has, I believe, a partnership with those guys over there. They make awesome introduction videos to WordPress and WooCommerce. I think they even have some SEO videos as well. So they're a great service that it looks like GoDaddy has partnered with to offer you some intro videos on how to get started editing your website. So we can go ahead and dismiss that tutorial. Here you can easily edit your tagline. It brings you over here on the left-hand side in the customizer right to that tagline screen. If you click here, it'll bring you to the site title. This bold statement here, we can click on that, and this just shows you that there's a widget here for a hero widget that appears on your homepage. You can edit the title right here, or you can edit this area here, grab your visitor's attention, and then also there's a button here that you can link to anywhere on your website. I'm going to go ahead and take a look at editing this content with the page builder and see how GoDaddy is working with that. So GoDaddy has partnered with Beaver Builder to use Beaver Builder as their page builder for brand new WordPress customers that sign up for GoDaddy hosting. So this is just asking us if we would like to take a quick tour of how to use Beaver Builder. So we can go ahead and say yes if we want a quick tour, or we can say no thanks if you just want to figure it out on your own. But this is a third-party page builder called Beaver Builder, and GoDaddy is just recommending them, and they have pre-installed it for their managed WordPress customers. I'm not going to go through all of the different options in the Beaver Builder page builder right now. That deserves a whole nother tutorial. There's a whole lot that you can do with this page builder, so we're not going to go into that right now. So I'm going to go ahead and close out of this. You can click Done up here in the top right corner when you're finished. I'm going to go and say just discard changes and exit because we really didn't make any changes in the page builder. When I do that, I actually get redirected back to our actual website. So this is the homepage of our website. At any point in time, we can come up here and go back to the customizer by clicking on this customize link up here. That takes you right back to the WordPress customizer, and you can edit all of these options here on the left-hand side. So I don't want to go into any more of the WordPress customizer. I will make a separate tutorial for that. I really just wanted to take a look at GoDaddy's quick start wizard process for new managed WordPress customers. And it's pretty smooth overall. They walk you through just some of the basics. They do ask you for some information that you might not necessarily be including on your site, but it's not too much and it is pretty simple to use, and they do walk you through it step by step. So I really like this GoDaddy onboarding process. I'd love to know what you think. If you're an existing GoDaddy customer and you've used this setup wizard before, please let me know how your experience went. There might have been things that you got stuck on. I'd love to hear your feedback and certainly provide that feedback to GoDaddy as well. They've been doing a really good job of listening to their customers and asking people for feedback, and they've actually acted on a lot of that feedback so far. So I know that they're trying to always optimize their onboarding process and make it as easy for new customers as possible to get started with their website and get things set up in a quick and easy way. So that does it for this tutorial. Thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next one. Thanks for watching, guys. If you enjoyed this video, you might also like one of these related videos below. And if you found it helpful, consider subscribing to our channel. Or check out our website at wpsmackdown.com for written tutorials and guides.